Good evening, everyone. Hey, let me ask you something. Do you like the winters here in Kuwait? Do you? I love the winters, especially the Friday mornings when I get to sleep for long under my cozy blankets. But you know what I love the most? It's my morning wake-up call. That is, the warm kisses on my forehead from my mom. They are simply exquisite. But then I wonder, what if I were in a boarding school? Alone, on my own, waking up to a screeching alarm from somewhere? Then, a thought crosses my mind. Is boarding school beneficial for children? Now, I would like all of you to imagine a six-year-old boy standing all alone on the doorsteps of a boarding school for the first time, watching the wheels of his parents' car turning, realizing with horror that they are driving away, feeling the very bottom of his little world falling out. Can you picture his eyes welling up with tears as he looks on? That's a tragic portrait of sorrow and solitude, right? Now, as I step back and look at the bigger picture, are boarding schools really that bad? Is it all doom and gloom there? Let's have a look, okay? Now, any Harry Potter fans out there? Raise your hands. Guys, I'm a die-hard fan. What if we had a Hogwarts school of witchcraft and wizardry right here? We have all joined hands down, right? Guys, that's a boarding school too. A bit glorified though. But in real life, you don't get broomsticks to jump onto by just flying into some magical land. Okay, on a serious note, boarding schools do offer a few positives. They often act as a refuge for children from broken families. Many offer quality education that is second to none. You get a lot of independence in learning, and you kind of mature fast. You get to make lots of friends. I mean, like, they live with you all the time. Okay, on a lighter note, you even get to see your teachers in their pajamas. Well, that's not always a pretty sight, though. Okay, now, what's the other side of the coin? Well, folks, you can sum it up in a single word. Boarding school syndrome. Which means you have trouble forming attachments. You can't hold on to intimate relationships. You come out of boarding school emotionally disabled. And it takes an awful lot of time to get back on track. So, what are the implications? Well, many of these kids end up in leadership positions. In positions of power. Politicians, doctors, lawyers, and so on, wielding substantial power on other people's lives. Now, therein lies the problem. Many of these emotionally estranged elites have learned to deny their own feelings, and they might as well deny others' feelings too. So folks, when you send your kid away, you are creating artificial orphan. There is no one to stand up for them. They are being allowed to fall through the cracks of society. Ladies and gentlemen, to be in your kids' memories tomorrow, be in their lives today. It's time we broke the social silence that surrounds this blatant injustice. It's time we polish our parenting patterns. So folks, kids here will be willing to go to boarding school. Well, I know I'm not going, no matter what. You know why? Because my mom